Now we've driven around to the entrance. This is the ocean side of the bar where the boats come through from George Basin. And the guy that's going to launch his boat here. Aboriginal midden, shells everywhere, and quite high up now. Amazing to think of them shell fishing here 10,000 years or more. The Bay of Fires was named by Cook or one of the guys sailing by years ago. Of all the campfires. That's looking north, the gardens where we had lunch, way up the green paddocks and beaches. And a bit further around to the right with our binoculars, we can see Eddystone Lighthouse. Somewhere there. It's just above this stick. Won't focus now. Hang on. It's just around that stick. Anyway, I'm better go back for dinner. Got a large pippy.
No, I think it's a
jammed in the crack.
More likely to be a one of those.
Get swept off the rock if he's not careful. We just headed off in different directions and got separated for 15 minutes. Perhaps we'll go back and have a beer now, or shall we go and look at some more sand dunes?
No, we'll have a beer.
Now the sun's going.
Get to the bottle shop before it's closed. St Helens
Island. And Morard Beach. Where we walked across these dunes earlier, a couple of hours ago. That's the restaurant, floating paddle wheeler. We had dinner on the other night. We're just going to head off from sunny St Helens down Bichen way now.
Looking towards Beaumaris, I would think.
Scamander Beach.
Scamander Forest Reserve and Scamander Beach.
Down to Beaumaris. Mm. Another long beach with nobody on it except the fishermen. This is Falmouth, just on the coast, past the lovely Georgian house. And the highway goes around the back of that. They advertise sun, surf and sea all the way down the coast. Lovely beaches. Lots of holiday makers from Hobart. Graham and Suze, you can camp here with your mates, your dogs and your boat, and then pop down to the water's edge. You're fishing and surfing on the silver sands. We've just stopped here for lunch of prawns. I'm just walking down to the beach here to catch up with Mary, and heard a bit of a rustle in the there he goes. It's called Little Beach and it's near St Mary's. We're on our way up
east
St Mary's,
down on the coast,
going up to have our pancakes.
As people are trying to get their dog to go for a swim, they threw the stick into the water and then said fetch, and it just stood there. Not. Why would it? Why? Just throwing it out again.
Yeah, well. Another midden on the coast. There's countless places they could live for thousands of years. All the wattles and the gums are flowering like mad all the way around down the coast here. Tent erecting time. The wide beaches stretch for miles. This is just half a mile south of where we just had lunch. Little Beach. St Helens is inland from here. No, St Mary's, sorry. Cottage.
it's not a problem.
Do you want me to take the curtains away?
No, I'm just commenting. I had some blue curtains like that, and they were very.
So I will look around, or have to have them made to size. But, there ain't.
Narrow ridge here coming back down from Elephant Pass, Elephant Mountain, and the Pancake Parlour, and over the edge from the car driving in the treetops. Now we came here with Glenn and Francis and Gillian 15 years ago. Walked around this beach to my left. Yep. And then we walked along the spit. There's a large resort there now. They might have bought the access to this spit here. We walked across here and out to the island, little island, Rocky Granite Island. Climbed around that for a while. Coles Bay, Freycinet National Park camp at night or so. Booked our return passage on the ferry and heading off into Wineglass Bay, Freycinet, and it's a walking track. One of the three peaks, Amos, etc., which are misnamed on one of the maps. 100 metres up the track. Steps to the top there. Lots of earthworks for the track. Nice boulder. Mary just said last time she wore those strides. Climbing up Mount Rockamadour, up the 39 steps.
Last time I wore them, it's the last time I wore them climbing up. Sing across it, Bill.
Just met a group of people that just whizzed up to the lookout and down again. This is a sign of hot days and cold nights. Highly variable rainfall around here. We noticed back at Coles General Store. These young folk can't hack it anymore. There's a slab broken off. A lookout back behind me. That is up there for a view of the bay. That's where David scrambled up. I think we all did actually. Had a look at the view from the rocks. Best views are up back behind the bushes. That's where we walk down. Had lunch with the wallabies 15 years ago, and then across around the point. There she is. And serious photographer footsteps everywhere on the rocks. Looks like one of the faces they abseil and rock climb off. I'm just heading down now and loving all these boulders. This one here has got a trachyte seam through it, a finer grain one, and the neighbouring rock they've rolled apart and it's at right angles to it. Most people have charged by without even noticing. The rest of it has tumbled down the hill there. We're just heading back to the car now. 20 to 1 at lunch. Well, we just had our lovely lunch with a free view just around from the Freycinet Lodge. This is Honeymoon Bay and the walk up to the view of Wineglass Bay is up over that saddle. We came around there in January 1990, and so that's Coles Bay, and we camp over there just over the ridge. I think one could happily camp in any of these little spots here, though it could be a bit windy. The Freycinet Lodge is up there somewhere. Windy little spot at the moment. Now there's people everywhere. So we'll head off to the lighthouse. This is Sleepy Bay. Fishermen have put in a good shelter spot and a strong northerly. And the colour's unreal, and that's without a Polaroid filter. That's around the end of Wineglass Bay. Glenn's definitely watching over us as far as the weather goes.